Hello viewers, welcome to our Facebook live session. Today we have with us our specialist Dr. Hemant Lahoti, consultant pediatric surgeon at Apollo Hospitals Navi Mumbai. Today we'll be discussing on pediatric surgery. Doctor, our first question is, what is pediatric surgery?
Well, in simplest terms, pediatric surgery is surgery done for children. Technically, it is less than 18 years of age, but from birth to about 15 years of age, all those children with surgical problems are managed by pediatric surgeons. Pediatric surgery is a highly specialized branch because child is not just a small adult. They have specific needs. Their surgery is different. The techniques are different. Diseases are different. And you need to be well conversant with how to handle a baby. Now, to achieve that, pediatric surgeons undergo 3 years of rigorous training in pediatric surgery so that they can do these delicate operations with high degree of precision and success for that matter. So all the body systems can be affected by surgical problems in children, and they are referred to pediatric surgeons for treatment.
So what are the common problems in children that they need surgery?
As I said, every system of the body can be affected by a surgical problem in children also. But we generally group the surgical problems in children according to their ages. Now, the most common group is what you call as a congenital anomaly or birth defect. Almost 3% of the newborns have some or the other type of birth defects involving chest and abdomen and sometimes urogenital tract. Fortunately, most of these abnormalities or birth defects are not serious and they can be treated electively after a certain period of time. But certain abnormalities involving the food pipe, windpipe and anorectal region are extreme emergencies which, if not treated immediately after birth, can lead to complications and sometimes death. So they are a major category of problems that we treat. The second category, which I like to call, is a diaper area abnormality, wherein area under the diaper, usually the urogenital tract abnormalities. The common problems here are noticed and diagnosed in infancy and school age children. The examples are hernias, hydrocele, undescended testes and hypospadias. The third common category is seen in an older child, 6 years and above. The most common problems in this age group are appendicitis, trauma, burns and so on.
When should I seek a help of a pediatric surgeon?
Typically, children suffering from problems are taken to their pediatricians or general practitioners, where they examine, diagnose and refer them to a pediatric surgeon. So, as a parent, you should not wait for the symptoms to escalate and develop into a major problem. You need to take your child to the doctor, to your doctor pediatrician immediately. As a general rule, there are 3 symptoms which you need to be looking out for: pain, swelling or bleeding. I said pain, swelling, bleeding. Now, if your child is suffering from any of these 3, then he or she is probably will require some sort of surgical intervention, wherein you should take help of a pediatric surgeon.
So, doctor, is age of the child a criteria for operation, and how safe are the operations for children?
This is a very important question because a lot of parents are scared of getting the surgery done for their small child, understandably so. But this delay or not doing the surgery in some cases lead to complications and sometimes mortality. In fact, the basic principle of pediatric surgery is correct treatment at correct time. So if you delay the treatment, you are bound to get into complications. For example, there is a very common problem in our children that is called an undescended testis. The testes have not descended to their normal position. Now, these cases are very common and they need to be operated between 6 and 18 months of age. Now, because of the small age of the child or because the problem is not painful, many parents delay the surgery, which is not good because beyond 18 months of age, the child is going to lose the testicular function and will be prone to complications like torsion, hernias, and even cancers. So if your expert has given you advice for surgery, don't delay. Go right ahead with it. Now, as far as the safety of the surgery is concerned, with the kind of technology that is available to us, especially in centers like Apollo Hospital, we have fantastic anesthesia backup, great intensive care setups, and whole lot of things which are required to do children's surgery very safely. So much so that in a very small baby who is just born, maybe a 1.5 kilo weight, we can safely tell the parents not to worry, your baby is going to be fine. So safety is not a factor in a regular case. But if the child is in complications or a very late stage of the disease, then yes, the risks are more.
Doctor, we come to the last question. Sonography during pregnancy is shown problems in baby. What should I do?
This is also a very important question. A large number of sonographies are done in pregnant women in our country, and about 3% of these pregnant women are found to have babies with abnormality, babies that mean unborn babies. And then the whole family is scared about the future of the baby. Now, these abnormality diagnosed women and the prospective family is referred to us for what is called as antenatal counseling. See, nobody wants an abnormal child, but fortunately, most of these abnormalities are minor abnormalities which are not life-threatening and which can be correctable with simple surgery. So abortion as a knee-jerk response to the abnormality is never a good idea. Now, when these parents come to us, we counsel them about the abnormality and prepare them for the treatment and the delivery of the baby in terms of financial, mental, and we generally educate them how the treatment of the baby is going to be. So please do not take option of abortion in every abnormality of unborn child. Majority of them will become absolutely normal after delivery and treatment.
Thank you, doctor, for joining this session. Dear viewers, if you have any questions related to this topic, please drop the questions in our comment box and we'll address it to Dr. Hemant. Thank you.
Thank you.